Hi guys, John here with more Firewatch. So last time we discovered a fenced off area nearby and couldn't figure out what it was, just left it there. And then a couple of days later we went to do some fishing. We found a clipboard which sinisterly had transcripts of the conversations between Henry and Delilah. We also found a radio which wasn't one of the orange one that Henry uses, it was red. And just as we were looking at it, we got knocked out. The clipboard got taken to us, from us. The radio got taken from us. We've no idea who did it. We've no idea why. But we suspect it had something to do with the fenced off area. So we made our way back there to try and see if we can get in it and investigate further. So that's what we're going to do. The only other thing that happened, I believe, was that there was a report that the two girls that we scared off of the lake weeks earlier have gone missing. They were supposed to go to their aunts and didn't. So the police are being called. Delilah's dealing with them. Henry said that he's happy to be interrogated, or you know, answer any questions rather. But we haven't had any update on that yet. Okay, so here we are at the fence.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
Well, see what you can do to get past it.
Thanks, Delilah, that's helpful. Okay, so see if we can go around the outside, see if we can see a gate or an opening. Get through the fence is my objective. Easier said than done. Probably not worth trying to get round on that side. Let's try the other direction before we do anything drastic. See where that leads. Just need a hole or, you know, a gap maybe, or a gate.
And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Okay, so I can't go through the gate. Okay, it's a bit of a stretch, but I wonder if we can break the lock.
Look, I'm not going to be able to get into this place. I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Oh, really? Look for control burns south of Ruby River. Oh man, Ruby River's all the way back. That's where I am. Yeah? And I've got to make my way all the way down to here. Okay, this is an area I've not been to before. I guess I've got to make my way back to Jonesy. Oh, actually. What's the best way of doing this? Jesus. Thunder Canyon, Two Forks, and then south. Maybe. Alright. Thunder Canyon's this way, I think. Whoops. Maybe not that way. How did I get here? Is that... No. Okay, seriously, how did I get here? Ah, here we go. I think. Oh, there's a trail down. Okay, good, right. So we've got quite a way to walk here. There's no fast there's no fast tracking that I fast traveling that I know of.
Nope.
I still can't believe we haven't seen any bears or anything yet. Or any real wildlife. We've seen the sort of stag at the beginning. And we saw, now if I remember right, the lake's that way and the cave's that way. So let's go this way. Yeah, we saw the stag at the beginning on our way to the lodge. And we saw the turtle, of course. But that was it. Which is all very surprising, really. You'd think there'd be more wildlife around. Oh, can I get through that? Yep, okay, so I think that's the cave up ahead. There's two forks, look out. No, there we go. Okay, so if I go back through the cave and
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Intercepting our frequency, I would have thought. They're not often they're following us.
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Okay, I'd have to question the fact that just because she doesn't know how to do it, doesn't mean it can't be done. Bit of a naive attitude, that one. Okay. So let's climb ourselves.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Okay, that's the lookout where we saw the dude spying on us before. Right at the beginning. Whether or not that's the same guy that knocked us out, don't know. Possibly. There's very few characters in this game, so you know the list of suspects is kind of short. Assuming it's someone we actually know about. It could be someone different altogether, I guess. There we go. Should have been much further now. all of Henry's problems with his wife and, you know, decisions he's made with his life and everything, like running away by coming here in the first place, he's one fit guy. All he does all day is walk and climb rocks. Okay, so here we are back at Lookout.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not going to try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Interesting. Okay, so we managed to get our way down to the canyon, through the canyon, and all the way back to Lookout. Two Forks Lookout. So south of Ruby River. So we've got to go... We've got to go towards the fire, really, haven't we? Okay. Come on in. There's a fire there. Can I get through? Oh, I can get through here. Hello, this is interesting. Have I done this before? Is that... is that Ruby River down there is what I was going to say. Oh, this is taking us away. Can I hop over this? Nope, I can go around it.
Whoa, Delilah, the trail I hiked in on, it's gone.
What is this, the Twilight Zone?
It's starting to feel like it.
Well, look, don't freak, okay? This happens. At the end of the summer, we just fly you out. Or, you know, if there's an emergency.
I'm sensing an emergency.
I can't call and ask for a $15,000 helicopter ride because there might be someone out here harassing us.
Well, let me know when you can, okay?
Okay, Henry.
Okay, I've gone a bit off track here, haven't I? Ah, oh, there we go. So I turned left when I should have kept going down. Okay. Let's backtrack, see what we can do. Interesting that I can't leave, though. Somebody wants to give me grief and they want to make sure I'm staying here to get it. Okay, that's probably where I went wrong when I went through the fence. Okay, there's the fire. Is this... Let's just quickly consult. This is Ruby River, so we want to go... That way. Right? Oh, man. Okay, let's get to that supply cache and see what's there. Okay, what we got? Map information as always. Another update in the bromance between Ron and Dave. Let's have a look at this. Really wish the powers could could issue us radios that don't suck ass. Most of the time I prefer to keep things pen to paper. Maybe once in a while it'd be nice to get a hold of you right away. My sister keeps leaving me messages at the main office, but I don't think she gets that. I took the job so I wouldn't have to deal with her or Mom. I've been sitting at the spot for a while now, thinking about what to say to her, but I'm a quarter way through a bottle of Fire instead. Miss you, Dave. Okay. Got some books, toilet paper, Jane here. And more pine cones. Okay, let's find firefighters in old scout camp past controlled burn.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to two forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Oh, hello. What we got here?
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
Okay, feeling better already. What about this one? Ah, this is the pond.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah, where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
I don't know what to say to that. Okay, let's get the map up. So we're at Pork Pond. So we're heading in the right direction. Let's just keep going then. I guess the camp's that way. Hello, what we got here?
Never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers. The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
Right, so what's doing it? Got the controls on this thing. Map, here we go. Yep, I'm definitely heading the right way. Okay, so yes, let's walk around and see what we can find. Maybe we can climb over like he says. Whoops. Go down there. Can we even go down there? No. Now, there's a way up here. No, too steep. No, I can't climb up here. Well, I can't walk up here anyway. No prompt to climb the rocks. Well, he said he'd walk the ravine, didn't he? So let's walk further. I don't know. Is it south? This way instead. Oh, hang on. Oh, it's just a tree. Oh, okay. Go on in. Oh. Look at that totem pole. follow the trail, see where it leads.
You ever talk to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, a marching band?
Oh, no. Like, comics. Model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragons armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good.
I'm not even going to bother commenting on that.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
Is this what I'm looking for? It is, isn't it? Yeah.
There are bear traps out here in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. That is pretty messed up. Jeez, this is dilapidated. Okay, well look, I'm here. There's no one else here. And it doesn't seem to be any tools either. Dead campfires. Abandoned structures. What am I supposed to be doing here?
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
However,
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge
help. For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Oh, yeah. Okay, hang on, what we have here?
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at...
Next few days, you and your team were dropping into the thoroughfare region of Shoshone National Forest to cut a fire line south of Ruby River. I'm writing you on behalf of Dr. Ben Simmons at Wapiti Station. Ah. He reached out to the superintendent with wildfire concerns about his research site. Upon your return, someone from his office will want to speak with you as part of a wildfire risk assessment of the region. I told them they have nothing to worry about and that your team's fire lines are the most potent preventative measure in protecting their site, even though they'll be more than a mile away. But I think they've got insurance companies to answer to. Thanks as always for your service. Rich Slusarenko. Wow.
Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversation. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone.
Okay, this is all getting, It is all turning quite dark quite quickly. I don't mean I don't mean the daylight. Right, so I need to go straight up to the river and cross it. Yeah. There's a research station at Wapiti Station behind that fence.
I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right. So, tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
Well, what about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Wow. So I didn't get to go back to the fence. What in the hell is going on? So day 77, this is the next day now. Here we go. Oh yeah, let's relax.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the 50th time today. The Flapjack fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
Seriously?
Are you kidding right now? Did you not stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Oh. Yeah, okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Which tree am I supposed to internalize again?
Top row, second from the left. Head to a place named after that tree, and you'll have a wonderful afternoon.
That sounds somewhat unlikely. Let's have a look. How far away is this? So we're looking. Oh, look, it's right back where we came from. Just a little bit east of where we were with the camp. Okay, well, that's good to know. Okay, we're going to take a break here. And when we pick this up next time, we will go. Oh, I took my wedding ring off. That's interesting. Put it on. Don't be a git. So I don't know what's going on. It's all getting a bit dark, but next time we're going to go to Cottonwood Creek and see if we can get some more clues. I'll see you all next time. Press like if you've enjoyed this, leave a comment below, and as always, subscribe and share. See ya.